kids, welcome to FABCON Ideas at Play. I'm your host, Doug Bryan. Today, we're overjoyed to be hanging out with innovative and inventive rhythm section of the legendary Rock and Roll Hall of Famers, Talking Heads, and the nucleus of the funkified, deep-fried groove machine known as the Tom Tom Club. Mr. Chris Frantz, drummer, and his lovely wife, Tina Weymouth, master of the four strings. Greetings. Thank you for being on FABCON today, guys.
Thank you, Doug. Welcome.
Evidently, you met at the Rhode Island School of Design in 1974, correct?
We graduated in 74, but we met before that. When I first met Tina, I said, oh, she's the one. And I worked it, too, with great savoir-faire and finesse.
I can't say I blame you.
He kept asking me to be in his band. It took 2 years, though.
Last night you mentioned that you might be the longest rock and roll marriage out there.
I think it's true. The secret is, what is the secret, Tina?
The secret is to remain interdependent, yeah, but not needy.
You founded Talking Heads as a trio with David Byrne in 75 or 4.
Our first concert at CBGB's, opening for the Ramones in 1975.
What were you listening to? What were the influences that formed the nucleus of Talking Heads?
In our record collection, we had Al Green, Otis Redding, James Brown, Fela Kuti, but we also loved Lou Reed, David Bowie, Roxy music.
I found out today, actually, that your first record was by sausage magnate Jimmy Dean. Is this true? Big Bad John?
Yes, that was my first, good for you. That was the first record I bought, first 45.
Big Bad John.
I love that record. Oh, man.
Well, did you ever think that cutting to 2002 that you would be inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame when you were sitting there listening to records as a child?
I had no idea, no. But I did love my records.
Big Bad John.
Tina, I wanted to ask you, what made you pick up a bass guitar?
Well, it was the instrument that was needed. I played flute, but Chris hated flutes.
I like it when you
yes.
play.
It doesn't fit in rock and roll.
Right.
In Kraftwerk, they did a great job. But anyway, I was living with Chris and David Byrne. They kept looking for bass players. Chris said, oh, come on, Tina, come on. He kept bringing home these Susie Quattro records and saying, you can do this.
He was right.
You don't care, but I'm just a punk girl doing it.
I think a lot of people are under the impression that the Tom Tom Club was something you guys formed after the Talking Heads was over. That's actually untrue. You guys formed Tom Tom Club while Talking Heads was on hiatus.
Correct. Talking Heads was doing very well, critically.
Critical darlings.
Yes, we were.
Yes, we were the little pets.
Right.
And we weren't getting a lot of radio airplay, and so our actual records were not selling in huge numbers. We did the first Tom Tom Club album and it just zoomed up the charts.
Totally awesome.
One of my favorite moments in my life was I was walking down Houston Street in New York City around the time of the release of Genius of Love, and all the kids had their boom boxes tuned to the same radio station. That radio station was playing Genius of Love.
But you know, it was wonderful because the success of the Tom Tom Club really helped spur Talking Heads and keep Talking Heads together. In effect, David Byrne had pretty much left the group at that time.
That was all pre-speaking in tongues though, right? So you guys like rebounded into speaking in tongues,
which was your biggest record,
and burning down the house and all that.
And now we're celebrating the 30th anniversary of Tom Tom Club this year. 30 years of funky, deep-fried
funky
effervescence.
And so you've recently released a live album, Genius of Live, and the reason you guys are here in Dallas talking to us today is to promote the 8-track museum, your friend Bucks Burnett, your friend and mine.
That's correct.
You guys are going to release a limited edition of Genius of Live on 8-track tape.
It's astonishing.
It is astonishing. That's the word I'm looking for. It's astonishing. Yes, indeed. I'd like to bring him on now as a special guest. So Mr. Bucks Burnett, please. This is your life.
It is my life indeed.
It and is. The A-Track is now
couldn't
your
be happier to living it.
What a character.
Format war is over. What does that mean, Bucks?
It's obviously a play on war is over, if you want it, from John and Yoko. I'm declaring war on the death of physical formats. I'm a formatician. That's the name of my job. Physical formats of any kind are holy to me at this point.
Even the ones that were on the back of like honeycomb cereal that you cut
especially,
out scissors?
Especially the cereal box 45.
Yeah, Bobby Sherman or something?
I think that all formats can live together in peace.
I want to ask, what's next for the Tom Tom book?
Our plan is to record some new stuff, 2011 being our 30th anniversary. We're going to be playing festivals in Europe and the United States and possibly Asia.
Well, listen, guys, I can't thank you enough for being on FABCON today.
Thank you, Doug.
Keep in touch with FABCON here, because in the future, we'll be doing a show just about the 8-Track Museum. So keep
Yay!
Looking for that, kids. Thanks a lot. I'm Doug Bryan. We'll see you next time on FABCON. Cheers.
Our friendship was so well cemented over music and art and good food and good company before we ever became romantically involved. So we were very compatible.